So, hi, my name is Ankalja. I'm here to tell you something about Freshmaker, which is new service we are going to deploy, or we want to deploy in Fedora, hopefully soon. The goal of this service is rebuilding container images and modules and probably some other artifacts in the future, like Flatpak, automatically when some dependency of those artifacts is updated. So at the beginning, I want to show you the topics I would like to cover in this presentation. So we will talk about motivation, I mean why FreshMaker is useful for people in Fedora and Fedora infrastructure. Then I want to cover like the way how it works, events and policies, container rebuilds, and in the end I will talk about the current status of the project and the plans for the future. And I will also ask you for help with the project. So let's start with the motivation. I think everyone here is a package maintainer or know how the things work like. Yeah, is it true? Okay, but I will briefly describe the current status. So if you are a package maintainer and you want to update your package, you want to change the spec file, then you commit the change to this git, submit it as a rebuild or as a build in Koji, which is build system, and then submit that to body, which is used for testing the package, and once the package is tested, it can be included in Fedora stable repository. And this is actually what package maintainer does, but it's not the last thing which has to be done with the package. Because we can have, for example, container images, and to get the updated package into the container image, we have to somehow ensure that the container image gets rebuilt. And this is kind of responsibility of a container image maintainer, because he should track the updates in Fedora stable and do the rebuild, or he can just blindly rebuild his container image like every week to ensure that updates are in. There's also another issue with container images, and that's layered container image rebuild. So container image can depend on another image, and once the parent image is rebuilt, someone or something needs to rebuild the children Docker container images. And this is also kind of hard to do because there's no official tool or official way how to do that in Fedora. Although this is not so big issue for containers in Fedora because there are not so many dependencies between containers, but the same issue exists, for example, for modules, because modules depend on each other much more often. And in certain times, we want to rebuild like module and all the modules depending on it and just all the tree, whole tree. And this is like also issue because you have to manually track the dependencies between modules. There's no official way how to do that or how to do it automatically. The same issue as with RPMs in containers exists also for modules. So you can have module which has RPM in it, and once the RPM or the package in the module gets updated, you want to rebuild all the modules containing that RPM to ensure that the module has the latest RPM. And now imagine that in the future we could have like modules included in container images. So once you rebuild the package, you have to rebuild the module, and you have to rebuild all the containers and all the layer containers. And that's how things are started complicated or getting more complex. Owen Taylor is also working on Flatpaks in Fedora, so that's another like way how we will distribute content, and we need to rebuild Flatpaks based on RPM updates too. So this is like current situation or problems we are trying to solve with FreshMaker. And as I said, FreshMaker is here to track the dependencies between all those artifacts, and once that artifact changes, it should depend all the artifacts depending on it. To do that, it listens on FedMessage bus. As I said, it's a service like running on Fedora infrastructure, and it listens for those events from various Fedora infrastructure services like Koji, Git, module build service. And based on those events, it triggers the rebuilds. It also has to track the dependencies between the artifacts, like what depends on what. And It uses PDC as a source for this information, and some details are also stored in Koji and Git. And as I said, when some event happens, it uses those information to rebuild all the depending artifacts on the all the depending artifacts which depend on the artifact for which the event has been like submitted. Yeah, it's important to say that PageMaker itself doesn't do the rebuild. It always asks some other service to do the rebuild, like module.service or Koji, so it's kind of orchestrator for those services. So that's like the main way how PageMaker works. Are there any questions like for these two slides? Because it's important, yeah, okay. You mean? Oh yeah. The question is if PageMaker triggers the chain builds. Do you mean like cross artifact types, like?
Well, let's say you check in a change to a spec file for some library, or a new version of the library. Do all packages that depend on that library also get removed?
They might be if the change is like breaking ABI, but normally if you update the library, you don't have to rebuild all the modules based on the library. But to get the library into the container image, you have to rebuild container images to actually get it there. So it triggers the rebuild of container images, but it doesn't trigger the rebuild of modules, because for library update, which is like shared object, it's not useful. Does it answer it, or?
Yes.
Okay.
So Hanzo, what will do store in Git or in like which Git repositories?
Sorry?
So the second point is that you track dependencies, and it's usually in PDC, but also in Koji and Git, like what's in Git?
So there might be something, but I'm not sure right now what it is. I mean,
okay.
We have some issues, we have some situations in Docker images where we need to actually find out what's in the Docker file, but I'm not sure right now.
Okay.
So let's move. Yeah, so this is the first part of a PageMaker. It does the rebuilds, and the second part is about tracking, because for example, as container image maintainer, once PageMaker rebuilds your image, you want to be able to find out like why it happened. So we have a REST API which can be queried, and it provides you the information that particular container image has been rebuilt because of update or following list of RPMs, or because of like layered image has been updated, and so on. And it works also the other way around, like as a package maintainer, you want to see what containers or what modules have been rebuilt using your RPM update. So you can query the PageMaker API for the NVR of the package, and you will see all the artifacts which have been rebuilt using that NVR. That way you can also track the progress of the rebuild. So in case you query the PageMaker during the rebuild, you will find out that some container images are still being rebuilt, some are already done, and so on. And you can track the progress of the rebuild like that. There are some plans to create user interface, which would show it in some nice way, but right now we have just the JSON output of PageMaker, but it's still useful. So as I said, there are multiple types of artifacts and events. For artifacts, it's quite clear, it's like container image, module, RPM, and so on. But for events, it's not so clear which event should trigger the rebuild. So for example, for container image, you can have three types of events which can be used to trigger the rebuild. The first one is when the RPM which is included in container image is built. The second one, when this RPM is tested or released. And PageMaker as a tool supports all those events, but it depends on your use case which one should be used. So for example, if you plan to use PageMaker as continuous integration tool, you want to build, for example, container image as soon as RPM is built. to be actually able to find out that that RPM broke the Docker image, so it broke the container image, and or the module, and so on. But if you plan to release, I mean build rebuild artifacts only to release them, you can actually be quite happy with rebuilding container images just when RPM is tested or it's actually released. So the goal of this slide is to actually tell you that FreshMaker supports a lot of events, but it depends on your use case which one should be used. And this use case is defined by a so-called policy, and that means that it's a configuration of FreshMaker which sets the boundaries to FreshMaker and sets like what should be rebuilt on what event and in what time in the pipeline. Because we cannot rebuild like every Docker, every container image or every module on every event, because that would mean that there will be just lot of builds and it's not good for the infrastructure. So we had to find some policies to actually do the useful rebuilds, but without abusing like Koji build system and so on. So there are two examples of policies. The first one is that we can, for example, combine multiple events to a single rebuild. So if you have container image and there is some RPM getting into Fedora stable, you queue that RPM and wait, for example, for 1 day or 6 hours for upcoming RPM updates, and then do the single rebuild with all those RPM. And there has to be some decision to actually decide what should be the time, you know, what should be the delay before we start rebuilding, and so on. Other situation is that, for example, for RPM updates which has some security impacts, you want to rebuild the container image as soon as possible to like have the updated RPM with security issue there really soon. And as I said, there's currently not clear answer to the question who decides the policy for Fedora, because it could be like special interested groups for Fedora, so for container images, or it can be FESCO and people like that. We definitely want to come up with some possibilities, what is even possible with FreshMaker and how it could work like, but you know, the delays between rebuilds, or if RPM security fixes should be handled as soon as possible, or we are okay with waiting with rebuild. It's just a question of a policy and someone has to decide it, yeah.
Is there a way to trigger a rebuild manually?
It's planned, it's not
so
there.
Basically, can we override the policy? So say we go for the multiple combined update artifact on a regular basis, and then we get security code that we want to do the ASAP. Can we override the policy and say, well, this one do it now?
Yeah, we can do it. It's not implemented right now because we have been postponed that because it's simple to implement. Yeah. So we are focusing on the hardware cases, but that's definitely planned before the deployment. We have to be able to control it like manually, or even stop rebuilding of something like in case it would case some problems. So that's it. More questions?
Can you show us the policy?
You mean like in configuration?
Yeah, how it looks like.
I can show it.
Yeah.
Well, I mean, I think I can. Or if you don't mind, I can show it in the end.
Yeah, I don't.
Yeah, because I will have to find it. It's not like something I would have prepared, and I'm not sure. I have a new laptop here, and I'm not sure where my things are. So let's get back. Policies. So yeah. So if we decide to rebuild something, what can be shipped? We have two ways how to do that. Again, I will talk about container rebuilds, but it's the same for modules. So the first way is that we can rebuild container once the RPM is in Fedora stable. So we have to wait for testing for the RPM to pass. And then when it is Fedora stable repository, we trigger the rebuild in Koji and we got the RPM we got the updated container image. This is easy to do. PageMaker supports that even today. But the problem with that is that container image cannot be released together with RPM, because the RPM is already released in the time when we start the rebuild. This like might be okay, but it's not the best thing to do, because ideally we would like to have the container image released in the same time as RPM. And to do that, we have to do the complex way of a rebuild, and that also has two ways how to do that, because to be able to release container image with updated RPM, we have to wait for that RPM to be signed, and that happens as soon as the RPM is submitted to body for testing, and we can then wait for the RPM to be really tested before it gets moved to the stable. So we can rebuild container image once the RPM is tested, but that wouldn't allow us to test the RPM and container image in the same time, because RPM is already tested, it's going to be in the stable, it's just a matter of the time before body actually meshes the update. But it gives us some time to actually do the rebuild before the RPM is in the stable repository and is seen on the mirrors. And even better, we can just rebuild the container image once the RPM is being submitted to body. So both container image and RPM can be tested in the same time, or more or less the same time, because the rebuild takes some time, but we can just bound it together and test it in the same time, and then even release them in the same time. The problem with that is that in case the RPM fails the tests, we will have bunch of container images which are actually broken right now. Like, they are useless because we cannot ship them because the RPM failed the test. And once we have the updated RPM with the fixed test, we will do the rebuild again. So it's again part of a policy if we are okay with rebuilding container images which may not be released, because we will find out later that the source of those container images are like broken.
The question, what's the problem with rebuilding the container images? Is it resources, or is there some other problem with it?
It could be resources.
Okay.
Yeah, that's the only concern, I think. And I'm not sure how heavy is to rebuild a container image, what's the resource impact of that in Koji. And if we decide to do that for all the container images and we plan to have more of them, or we decide to do it for Flatpak and modules the same way, it can be a problem.
There's also the reverse problem of if you're bundling the updates and the RPM test succeed but the container test fail, does that block the release of the RPM? And that's another policy that has to be defined.
Yeah, it's good. And actually, those policies should be defined by GreenWave, which is another talk Matt has after mine talk here, so you can just stay here to find out more information about how the tests will be gating. So I will go to another slide. This is really important to say, because the work of FreshMaker ends with all the artifacts being rebuilt. It doesn't do the releasing part. So for example, if it rebuilds modules, it won't submit them as an update to body. It really just do the rebuild thing. There are some plans to do another tool which will take output of FreshMaker and do the release. But for now, we plan to just email maintainer of a container image or module, saying him that here is the updated container image for you, and it contains following RPM updates, or it has been rebuilt because of following reasons, and it's up to you to actually decide if you want to really submit this as an update, or you want to do some manual changes there, or as a container image maintainer, you probably know that it's not the right time to do the update. I don't know, but yeah. Ingo?
And we need to figure out another way to do that. Well, not necessarily another way, but something else in addition to that, because sending an email to the maintainer is one thing, but it's not public. We need a place where people interested in container maintenance can actually see what's going on and see which container can be built and its kind of presence. So maybe there is a place for a seed list or something that would be CC'd to these emails. Because like the container maintainer could be, you know, on vacation for 3 months.
Yeah, I know.
So if he's the only person getting the emails about that and no one else knows about it, then it's lost.
And a dashboard of some sort that anyone
can
look at would be a real good thing, too.
Yeah. I think the easy fix would just be to CC the atomic working group for now until we collectively say that's a lot of traffic, but you know, we can work on long-term solutions outside of that. But yeah, just I think that's a good point, at least having a mailing list point.
Yeah, you can also build something like dashboard on top of that, because the data are in the Bridgemaker database. It's just not a matter of like getting them in some useful format.
Yeah, and that sounds great. I figured requesting a web dashboard would be a considerable amount of work compared to adding a CC to a mailing list.
Yeah, that's true.
But yes, by all means, please make a dashboard. That would be awesome.
Yeah, there are some plans to make, like Mike said. Yes. Okay, Mike?
Yeah, I was just going to say, so all the Freshmaker is going to be announcing the status to the bus, the message, just like everything else, so it would be probably pretty easy to do some FMM integration and have people sign up for whatever notifications they want.
And I wanted to say that Mike asked yesterday like for contribution to some kind of a dashboard or pipeline overview thing which would just show what's the status of the rebuilds, and not just the rebuilds, but like if you do an update of a package, how far is that in the pipeline, and you can track the progress of that package update. So that's something we would like people to contribute to, because like we don't have time for every part of that initiative. So
also at least does Freshmaker have a command line? So
it's not a command line tool. It's like service running in Fedora infra.
Yeah, I mean, but is there a command line tool to query the API so I can see the list of rebuilds?
I mean, you can use curl.
Or write a serious command line tool.
Yeah, we could have that.
Mm.
But right now we have just JSON API. Yep. So after the flock, right now we are discussing the policies with, next question.
Yeah, on the last slide. When you say release maker, is that meant to be a replacement for Bodhi?
Sorry?
More like something as like orchestrating creation of Bodhi updates for container, right? So the first maker rebuilds them, and then something has to create the update in Bodhi. In some cases, you might want to do that automatically, so that you know people don't have to put buttons and add those. They say, oh, sure, go ahead and create updates for all the security fixes that go into the container. Maybe you can also make that improvement. So, separate service is not fungible at all.
Yeah,
that's
true.
So right now we want to define the policies to FreshMaker project to actually make it useful for Fedora. So we are discussing that with people here. And this is something we need to do before the deployment, because we need to like find out what should be the pipeline for the FreshMaker to make useful rebuilds without breaking Koji. And in the first phase of deployment, we would like to focus more on modules, because like the problem with updated components in modules and the need to rebuild the module when the component is updated is kind of our first use case, and after that we would like to focus on containers. You can even do it like in the same time, but really there's the need to do the modules at first. And I think, yeah, how to get involved. So it's useful for us to discuss the policies, and even right now when you know what FreshMaker can do for you, you can find out some more use cases. So we would like to be interested, or we are interested in those use cases which we don't cover right now. You can contribute to code, of course. There's a link to PageMaker Pegur repository where the code can be found. And you can found us in Fedora Modularity channel on Freenode or even Fedora Relink, I don't know. And there's my email, right? You can just write me if you have some questions or improvements. So that's actually my last slide. So if you have further questions.
So will you be submitting a new change for Fedora 27 with the policies, or how are you planning to do it?
That's a good question. We were just started, you know, talking about them, and I will have to ask like people around PageMaker to find out if that's a good way how to do that thing. Because right now we have like the tool, and we have found out that we need to like really define how it should behave in Fedora infra. So,
but I think a good place to start would be, what is the policy today? Like, how often are things getting rebuilt and released? Because we could just, as a step one, we could just duplicate the current rebuild policy and process in an automated way, so it's not actually changed, and then we can decide if that's sufficient, or do we want to do things more frequently, or handle more use cases in an automated way. So it's, we're not trying to, I think this tool is trying to like change the world, and you know, that's the first step. But it's just trying to take, you know, trying to save Adam some time and remove people from the equation where it makes sense.
On the container front, yeah, you just tell us how you want to work on
it. Right now, we just do rebuilds every 2 weeks. I would love for it to be more frequent, but right now I do a rebuild before the 2 week release comes out. It's all by hand, so I have like this really shoddy script that maps out the dependency of parent images to child images, and I build them and promote them in order. It's bad.
Let's get a copy of these papers to write it down.
Yeah.
Okay. Models one in other cases.
Cool.
There are some planned changes in OSPS as well to provide more metadata around the parent child relationship.
Yep.
And I have one, so that's just how it's
done. Yeah.
Maybe we just ask like people in the room, what are the expectations around how often a Fedora container should be refreshed, or should be updated?
As little as possible and as soon as necessary.
I mean, I think we should be generating them as often as physically possible, but it should be entirely on the user's end when they want to pull it.
Right, so as often as physically possible would be, whatever, 7 times a day or however often something gets pushed to stage and pulled. But, so, I mean, that's possible, but we have to decide if we have the resources and it's useful to...
Well, and every time a rebuild happens, it lands in the candidate registry, when we only promote them at a predetermined period of time, or like time cadence. So I mean, we could, if we want to be doing rapid rebuilds for the sake of testing and whatever, cool. But we can still kind of keep a pretty standard schedule for actually promoting the latest that were pass tested to be advertised to users. So and a lot of that is just opinion. I don't care. Right now it's every 2 weeks. We could do it daily. I don't think a lot of users would be super excited about every time they like turn their computer on, they have to pull down the other JSON.
Okay, it's over.
Anyways, we probably have time, and I think we've derailed quite a bit.